Stand by. 60 seconds to air.
Standing by.
Activate ERS. Global Radio Network Power Grid. Initiating power up sequence.
ERS Global Radio Network coming online. Transmitter at 50%.
Commence affiliate uplink protocol. Establishing uplink. Connection established. The United States is now online. Canadian uplink connection established. United Kingdom uplink secured. Australia is now online. Slovakia online. South Africa is connected and online. ERS Global Radio Network is online.
Transmitter at maximum. Peak power is established and stable.
Microphones and headphones at full volume.
The Electric Radio Show is now on the air.
Oh, yes, all we are.
Yeah.
Back to entertain, maybe even shock some of you out there. Mm-hmm. How's it going, everyone? We hope you had a great week. Welcome to another Electric Radio Show. Coming up on the show tonight, I'm going to start with this. In the Underground Spotlight, you got a great group, man. The name of the group is Sir Curse. The name of the tune is called Tarot. And when we get into the Underground Spotlight, we'll tell you, you got to watch these guys on YouTube.
Awesome.
Because 50% of what you hear is in the presentation. Of these guys.
These guys are so good.
So it's very dark carnival. I love it a lot. But like I watched the video and immediately subscribe YouTube, Facebook, Instagram.
Yeah, I'm an instant fan too.
Yeah, very. So we've got Sir Curse coming up in the spotlight. Ice Cream Dreams.
Yeah, Cream Dreams.
Can you give us a little hint?
Yeah, we're going to talk about how ice cream can actually help you sleep better. And I figured this was good for you, Jack, because you have a lot of sleeping issues.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, later on in the show, I'll tell you about a sleep issue.
Especially after the other night when you texted me at 2:30 a.m.
Dude, I got some freaking sick sleep problems, man. I've had them before, and they're even worse now.
Yeah.
So Andre's going to tell us about Ice Cream Dreams. And got a guy in Canada who has a license plate plea to the country of Canada. So I'll tell you all about that. Clay Johnson, who did a great job last week.
Excellent.
Welcome, Clay Johnson, our new news guys here with the headlines. Hollywood Hotwire, Zodiac Maniac, we've got it all. Stick around because it's just getting started, so strap in, buckle up, cinch them up tight. This is the Electric Radio Show.
I was listening to the broadcast and I was wondering, what exactly is it?
This show will have laughter, tears, topless arguments, infections caused by jacuzzi water.
It's really weird.
It's about to get a whole lot weirder.
It's showtime.
Time for my favorite show.
Is it on now?
What time is that show again?
It's on now.
For real?
For real.
And we're on it now.
Okay, here we go.
All right, it's showtime.
We're starting the show, and it's going to be really, really good, and there will be people saying words and stuff, and you're going to like it a lot, and you'll be happy, and you won't want it to stop, yeah.
The Electric Radio Show. We have wires. We have electricity. Don't get us wet.
You guys are so sexy and funny. Oh, here's your coffee. Have a great show.
You're listening to The Electric Radio Show.
It's The Electric Radio Show. All right. Let's give you guys a peek into what went on in our weekly lives with our segment called What's Up. Considering he had nothing last week, got to have something this week. What's up, Andre?
I got nothing.
So. Oh, come on.
No, I'm just kidding.
Damn,
I'm
dude, you lead the boringest damn life.
I'm only kidding. So lately, I've been going through Dunkin' Donuts because, you know, I can't do anything without a cup of coffee in my hand.
I hear you.
So I've been going through Dunkin' Donuts, and I've been doing, like, these funny voices through the drive-thru, to get my son to laugh because he loves when I do that stuff. So this morning, I was doing, the lady was taking my order and she called me honey.
She said, boy.
Okay, pull forward, honey.
Did Gailey come out?
So, one of them. And I was like, okay, thank you. And then we pull around and it was a guy. It wasn't the lady who said honey. She was just on the voice thing. So it was a dude standing there. So I was like, oh, thank you, honey. And my son was dying laughing. And I do that all the time.
So Andres, what's up is voice choice. Before I go to the next one, dude, I went past our Dunkin' Donuts when we were doing this show at the radio station.
Okay.
Do you remember the night that you and I left? We were riding together. Andre ordered coffee at the Dunkin' Donut drive-thru.
Yes, I do.
And as he's driving around to the window, I put my hand on his thigh, yeah, on his inner thigh.
Well, that
and I wouldn't take my hand away. So
I believe I was doing some funny voices that night.
Andre
also, wasn't I?
Was laughing so hard. And I'm like, what are you laughing at? It was so funny.
Yeah, that was funny.
Andre's voice choice. Dee-lite.
I have this love-hate relationship with Amazon. I love Amazon. I order all the time. It's just convenient as hell, okay?
I agree with you. I order almost everything
from
Amazon.
I love their add-on stuff, okay? Because mm-hmm. you can get stuff really cheap, right?
Yeah.
So the other day I had a big order and they had the... All right, so I like eyeshadow. You guys know what that is, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I've heard of it.
All right. Yeah. So it was an add-on. It was like half the price that it normally is. I get my delivery today. They threw the eyeshadow in a big box with cat food and cat treats and...
Oh, boy.
So like it wasn't packed individually?
No. It was just all thrown together?
And it was just a big hot mess. The whole... the eyeshadow was completely just... All I could think was that it was a guy that packed this and he has no idea that... an eyeshadow is what it is. You know what I mean?
So knowing Dee-lite as well as I think I know her, you were probably on the Amazon chat.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
So are they going to replace it?
They are replacing it, yes.
Do they want the old one back?
No, because if they asked me for the old one back, I was gonna just send them a picture of the mess that the...
Oh, my God.
But wow. I love Amazon, but, like, come on, people. You got to get with the program here with... packing the stuff up.
All right. Your what's up is prime crime. Yo.
Well, my what's up involves you.
Me?
Yes, you.
What the hell? And I haven't seen you in a week.
Well, that's the whole point. Last week.
You've been touching yourself again.
Well, that's besides the point. I mean, you know, that has nothing to do with you. Maybe.
That reminds me. Maybe I'll have a burrito after the show.
Beef or chicken?
Probably beef.
So, last week, I was telling you I had an issue with my car. And
yes.
It was overheating and stuff like that.
Yes.
And, you know, every time I looked in the radiator, I would look at the conventional radiator, not the overflow.
Right.
And it looked full. So I did what you told me to do last week, and I did it through the...
The coolant tank, the coolant reservoir. You look at a cold level and a hot level.
And it took the whole bottle.
Yeah.
And then now I have no heating problem.
See that?
Wow.
So thank you.
So your what's up is Cool Cat Jack.
That's right. Cool Cat Jack.
All right. Well, I'm glad you fixed it. We got to get the headlight issue resolved.
It's done.
Done?
Yes. By the way, the it doesn't fall down. I just had my hand cramped up for 2 hours after I got it in there.
But you got it in there?
Yeah, I got it.
So your what's up is headlight tonight. There
yeah,
you go.
Sorry, baby.
let me see. Andre has done a couple of our podcasting friend shows. You've done a couple.
Mm-hmm.
You've been on. Well, I didn't know, but our good friend, Jeff Chandler.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Jeff has done, he's an amazing artist. He has Art Gecko Studios. I got in touch with Jeff just out of, I haven't reached out. We haven't talked to each other in a while. And Jeff now has a podcast.
I heard that. I heard through the grapevine.
And Jeff was like, Jack, why don't you come on the show? Why don't you, I never do these. Mm-hmm. Like, I never do these. But it was Jeff. And for those of you that are just joining us or your new listeners, we did Star Wars trivia with me head to head against Jake Lloyd. And I love Jake to pieces. I really, Jake is an awesome cat. He played Anakin Skywalker in episode one.
Right.
And I got to get a hold of Jake. I haven't talked to Jake in a while.
We actually have that video up.
Oh, do we? Yeah, we have the video?
I think it's up on our website.
Jeff Chandler wrote the Star Wars trivia questions that neither Jake nor I were privy to. And he made me and Jake look like Star Wars idiots.
Yeah, because he's like a super geek.
Yeah.
With Star Wars stuff.
You know, I loved it. Like, Jake's rebuttal was, because Jeff was asking, like, all these questions about Star Wars and New Hope and stuff like
right,
that.
Right, right.
Jeff was, Jake Lloyd says, I was in episode one.
He was like, I was like so, four when that movie came out.
Great. So anyway, so Jeff has done so much. He designed our original ERS logo.
Yep.
You know, I did everything. So it's Jeff. So I went on Jeff's podcast, which is out now, and you guys got to check it out. It's usually only a 1 hour podcast. I go on, it's 2 hours.
That's awesome.
So it's called the TMI podcast, and I'm going to put a link to it. I'll have Dee-lite link it in there. I have to honestly tell you guys, it's Jeff, because I don't have permission to mention anybody else's last name on here. You know, they didn't say yeah or no, but it's Jim, Jeff, and Mike. I guess Mike is the last guy. Mike.
Okay.
These guys, it's like an audio version of Comic Book Men. I had so much damn fun
that is
with
awesome.
These guys.
That's great.
Cool.
That's great.
And, I mean, they haven't been doing it that long. They've only been doing it for, like, I want to say they've been doing it for, like, 46 or 50 episodes. I'm going to put a link up. Excuse me. You guys got to check this show out. I had so much fun, and I want to thank these guys for even asking me to come on the show. It's the TMI podcast, and I'll link it in there and listen to the episode. Jeff is such a freaking nerd. So is Mike and Jim. Actually, Jim is extremely knowledgeable. I think you guys will love the show, man.
Awesome.
Check it out. I can't wait to hear it. TMI podcast. If you want to check them out right now, excuse me, I'm losing my voice tonight. I guess I need more gin. I think it's at TMI Podcast 2018. You could check them out. We'll link everything up.
Cool.
But Jeff, Mike, Jim, thank you so much for having me on the show. I had a blast. You guys got to check this out. It was a lot of fun.
Awesome.
So coming up in just a little bit, he's ready to go. Clay Johnson with the headlines. I laugh every time I say that. On the Electric Radio Show.
You may have heard that the company that makes conversation heart candies, you know, the ones with the little sayings like, hug me, kiss me, be mine, and so on, are not available this Valentine's Day due to bankruptcy. It's sad, but there's an upside. As the new owners, we plan to use the downtime to change the phrases that some people found offensive and replace them with ones more appropriate by today's standards, like, let's shake hands. You get a back pat. You're a pal. We're just friends. And, no! They'll be ready for Valentine's Day 2020. The new and improved Conversation Hearts. For candy that's every bit as stale as your relationship.
The Electric Radio Show.
Yeah, it gets me in the zone. Keeps, like, it kind of, like, tunes everything else out for me.
The hottest radio show on the planet.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Let's get right to those headlines. Where all the news, it is the news. Wouldn't be the news without him. It's the news guy from the newsroom, Clay Johnson.
This is Clay Johnson with an Electric Radio Show news brief. Tonight, we start with breaking news. An entire hour has gone by without a Virginia Democrat confessing that he once wore blackface in college. And now the news. President Trump recently gave his State of the Union address. I found it very moving. Unlike Nancy Pelosi's face. Elizabeth Warren apologized to the Cherokee Nation for claiming she was a Native American. Then she ruined it by offering them a hit from her grandmother's peace pipe. The next Mission Impossible movies will come out in 2021 and 2022. Of course, the real impossible mission during that time will be telling apart the 39 Democrats running for president. A courthouse in Oklahoma had to close after bedbugs were seen crawling on the clothes and neck of a lawyer. I can't believe my body came in contact with such a disgusting creature, said the bedbug. Scientists in Israel say that they're near a cure for cancer, which means the leading cause of death in the world will become Chicago. Pink received a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. It's at the corner of Hollywood Boulevard and Gary Busey sleeping. A one-armed college student in Spain used Legos to make himself a prosthetic arm. The only problem is he has to give it up whenever his little brother wants to build the Millennium Falcon again. And finally, Jeff Bezos accused National Enquirer publisher David Pecker of trying to blackmail him with publishing pics of Bezos' junk. In other words, Bezos has publicly exposed Pecker. This is Clay Johnson with an Electric Radio Show News Brief.
Stick around. Coming up next, who knows, man? Andre says ice cream can help you sleep. Mm-hmm. Tell you all about it coming up on the Electric Radio Show.
Thursday. St. Valentine's Day. With high-powered, estrogen-driven, testosterone-fueled, romancing and dating love. Get ready for the overpriced flowers. The chocolates. The mushy greeting cards. The overbooked restaurants and more. It's the essential, mandatory, Hallmark manipulated holiday of the year. Don't miss the pressure, the guilt, the expectations, and the jewelry store commercials. Thursday. St. Valentine's Day. You better be there.
We're going to have a lot of fun. We got some wonderful people for you.
All you mommies and daddies out there who complain to the radio station, I got something to say to you.
And the first thing you've got to do is say the call letters properly. Okay.
It's an incredible metamorphosis of love and emotion and sensitivity and tenderness and fun and joy and happiness.
Did you know that this show represents health and hope?
The Electric Radio Show.
It's the Electric Radio Show. According to Andre and his story, ice cream can help you sleep.
That's right.
Gives me gas.
Does it really?
It does.
Oh, okay. Well, thanks for sharing.
I sleep better. My wife doesn't.
So there's a company, and they're called Night Food, and they just created ice cream that helps you sleep.
Oh, okay.
So it's very different than regular ice cream, but regular ice cream is not really good for you to sleep anyway.
The dairy, man, it's not.
Well, it's
everything I hear is not cool.
It's got a lot of sugar to begin with.
That's true.
Intake a lot of sugar, it doesn't really help you sleep.
Right.
It gives you a lot of energy. So also, ice cream has, well, some ice cream has caffeine.
Mm. Oh yeah, chocolate. Yeah,
that's chocolate, right. Some of the, you know, the coffee.
Yeah, coffee, yeah.
And stuff. So anyway, Night Foods ice cream has extra protein and lots of other amino acids and enzymes that are supposed to help you fall asleep. So it's very low calorie. So it's kind of like that Halo top and all that stuff.
Hmm.
And it's got about 320 calories in a pint.
Wow, so, the whole pint?
The whole pint.
All right.
Wow.
So
low calorie count?
Low calories.
Helps you sleep?
And yeah, and it helps you sleep.
Wow.
Not bad.
So
not bad.
What's the catch?
Thinking.
Exactly, Dee. You took it right out of my mouth.
There's no catch at all. As a matter of fact, it says
$20 per pint.
Yeah.
You can buy the pints now on their website. And they have 8 different flavors. And it says that they're going to be out in the grocery stores later this year.
So. Came out the website. What's the website?
I don't have that.
Oh, okay. Well, there you go.
But I'm sure you can.
Sorry, sucker. Continue with your insomnia out there.
No, you can run a search. Run a Google search for Night Food ice cream.
Night
see what
food
you can find.
Ice cream. Dee-lite?
But
hop on your magic Android.
I'm on it.
I was thinking, jeez, you
why
know,
not? You maybe hop on everything else.
Hey.
Ooh.
What? No, I mean every time we do a story. Right? Every time we do a
That's
story.
That's messed up.
No, it's not messed up. Right? Every time right, we do a right, story, right, yeah. Dee-lite's hopping right on the freaking phone.
Well, you know, she's
you right. Hop on everything else, hop on this.
She's right there.
Well, so hop on this, Dee-lite.
Yeah, Get out of here.
So I was thinking, maybe we should try and get some of this for you, Jack.
$5 a pint.
Oh, that's still not bad.
That's
crying out loud. Ben and Jerry's is expensive. They're like $4.
Yeah.
I would do more than that. I would definitely eat that to try to sleep better.
We're going to reach out to this company and see what they can send us.
Yeah, maybe they can send us something. Or a coupon, at least. Pick it up, you know?
10% off, son.
No, give me a free coupon. I want a free pint.
Send the ice cream,
review it. I'll review it. I swear to God, I'll review the product. Because I take an enormous amount of stuff to go to sleep.
Right.
I'm not even kidding. Like, I take stuff that would put a horse down. I take just to go to sleep, and I take it every night.
Mm-hmm.
And I have like this pill container that I keep next to my side of the bed on the nightstand. And dude, God bless my wife, man. She gets me this container and it's like a vault almost, because we're worried about the cats getting into it. We don't, God forbid, you know.
Right.
So you open up the main lid and then there's 7 compartments that she has labeled Sunday through Saturday. All right. So I go to take the stuff to go to sleep. I take it, but it was, I don't know, we'll say it was like Tuesday night, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And I inadvertently took the stuff for Wednesday.
Oh, no.
Oh, boy.
Now, what I do
is... Is that bad?
Well, no. Well, this is where it can be.
You just swap it
around?
And
I'm not going to make this bit go long. But normally what I'll do is I lay in bed and there's nights that I'm so exhausted I just fall asleep. But the problem is I don't stay asleep.
Mm.
Like, I'll fall asleep for maybe an hour or two and then I'm up for the rest of the night.
That stinks.
So it is. It's terrible. Sleep disorders are the worst. They're terrible. So I took this stuff and I fell asleep. My wife comes in to check to see if I took my stuff. She looks at Tuesday
and sees
and all the stuff is there. So she wakes me up. She is like, as usual, she'll wake me up. Come on, you didn't take your stuff. So I take this now second handful.
No, you didn't.
I swear to God.
Were you just sleeping?
Yeah, I was out. I was asked out. So I now take this second handful.
Oh, man.
And I'm telling you, it is a freaking handful.
Oh, my God.
And she's like, come on. She said, hey, jackass, you didn't take your stuff to go to sleep. My wife has all these cute names for me. So now I'm half asleep, I'm groggy, boom, I get a mouthful of these things, and just as I'm ready to take the water, just picture, here, let me put an ice cube in my mouth.
I think I already took these.
Oh my gosh. And you spit them
and
out?
And she looked, and the compartment for Wednesday was empty.
So you spit them out.
So she's like, oh my God, spit these out! So I'm... I spit these things out in a paper Dixie cup. I spit them out. She throws them away. And she said, you could have died, you effing jackass.
Oh, my gosh.
And so I just roll over and go back to sleep.
Jack's washing it down with whiskey.
So, yeah, like, I roll over. Dude, I swear to God, she said, you could have died, you effing jackass.
Well,
so
serious?
I was like, I'm ready for sleep. So I went, just rolled over and went to sleep. So the next night, she gets home from work. I get home from work. And she goes, dude, you know what you did, right? And I'm like, yeah. I said, I vaguely remember it. I said, I think I spit them out, right? She goes, yeah, you're damn right you spit them out. And I just started laughing hysterically because all I could think about was Cheech and Chong's Up in Smoke when Tommy Chong goes, here, man, take these, man. Take this. And then Cheech takes them and he goes, oh, wait, don't take that, man.
Yeah.
Oh, I already took them. Wow, man. Wow. You just took the most acid I've ever seen anybody eat in my life. But, dude, I could have died. I mean, seriously.
That's really scary.
I could, at the very least, I could have went into just a minor cardiac infarction. I could have freaking died. You know, but she said, now I got to look and see if the day ahead's empty or something else is empty. So my wife saved my life.
Well, it's a good thing that she pays attention to that
stuff. Yeah, thank God, man. Or she otherwise could have just left me alone and I would just sleep. There you go. So Ice Cream Dreams, try out. What's the name of the company again?
Night Food.
Night Food. Check them out. Look them up. Google search Night Food. Coming up in just a little bit, you're going to freaking love these guys. Sir Kurz coming up with Tarot and the Underground Spotlight on the Electric Radio Show.
Happy Valentine's Day.
I scheduled a root canal for February 14th.
Hey, it's our first Valentine's Day together. You can't just drive through a Taco Bell or take a bullet.
Who pushes for a first date on Valentine's Day?
What is romance?
You figure it out.
My wife says she doesn't want anything for Valentine's Day, so I'm off the hook, right?
It's got what it takes. So tell me, why can't this be love?
I'm having oral surgery and skipping Valentine's Day. Doctor's orders.
Oh my God, that makes it even more romantic.
I kissed a girl and I liked it.
I want to know why can't this be love?
Since it's Valentine's Day, I was thinking, let's do something we've never done before.
Would you be my Valentine?
No!
I think we got a show.
Oh, yeah, we got a show.
We definitely got a show.
Oh, yeah, there's a show.
I wasn't playing with myself in the bathtub. I was just cleaning it, and it went off.
I thought I told you never to interrupt me while I'm working.
Hey! What are you trying to do?
So crazy someplace else. We're all stocked up here.
Don't mess with me. I'm one crazy mofo.
Go ahead. Make my day.
This show sucks.
Well, this whole place sucks. That's right, it sucks.
Due to some content, parental discretion is advised.
I am the thing from Uranus.
You can lose that smart mouth right now.
You just don't get it, Leah.
It is a thrill. I love this show.
The dead have risen and is voting Republican.
I'm George W. Bush, and I approve this message.
And I approve the Electric Radio Show.
All right.
Yeah, man. I took a lot of drugs when I was younger. Preface that, when I was younger.
All right.
Maybe a couple of weeks ago. All right, never mind.
Legal drugs.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Like, you know, to help you sleep.
Holistic.
Right.
Yeah, they really stick in that hole, too. Coming up in a little bit, Dee-lite's all fired up and ready to go. She's going to give you all the deets from Tinseltown. She's got the Hollywood Hotwire on the way. Dude, there's a guy in Canada that is actually pleading with the country just to get a stupid vanity plate. Unbelievable, but true. So let me see. Where in Canada? Saskatchewan.
Oh, okay.
The booming metropolis of Saskatchewan.
No, that's not a metropolis. That's the province.
I know.
Oh.
Just being sarcastic.
Oh, I didn't know if you actually
I'm being
knew.
My cute and charming self.
Okay, I'm sorry.
And straight ahead, I think you guys are going to absolutely love this. In the Underground Spotlight, our featured artist of the week, Sir Kurz. Say it fast. Say it fast. Sir Kurz.
Sir Kurz.
With the tune Tarot on the way on the Electric Radio Show.
It's Norv Schindler's extra large Valentine's Day adult toy super sale. A sale so big, it'll pump you full of savings. Just listen to this great selection of Valentine's Day pleasurable adult toys. Salivating Salamis, the Unholy Taco, Satan's Forefinger, the Probing Nun, the Naughty Plunger, the Woolly Mammoth, English, Italian, and French Ticklets. We don't discriminate. All half off and ready for love. This sale is big, long, and I need relief. Cupid's on a mission this Valentine's Day, and his arrow isn't the only thing standing at attention. All of our discreet and safe adult toys are FDA approved, and they come with free batteries. So don't miss out. All consenting adults are welcome. Norv Schindler's extra large Valentine's Day adult toy super sale. Come on down, because I'd love to please you.
The Electric Radio Show podcast will have you laughing so hard you may just pee your pants.
Oops, sorry.
Jack and Andre are not responsible for your dry cleaning.
The Electric Radio Show.
It's the Electric Radio Show. And this is really, and I'm not even being, you know, exaggerating. This has always been one of my favorite parts of the show. And you know what? This is all due to Andre Kane. Because Andre is the one that came up with this whole idea that we should feature. At the time, we were on in the Dutchess Ulster County market of New York. And Andre's like, man, maybe we should just have like local musicians submit stuff and we'll play it on air in a segment, and we'll give it a name. And we somehow came up with the Underground Spotlight, and we've had that name since 2008.
Yeah, it's been a long time.
And as a matter of fact, the first person we ever picked for the Underground Spotlight is John Schrader.
That's right, it was.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. And you know, it's a dubious honor having John, everybody. John.
Yay!
John just comes out of nowhere at times.
Well, it's because, you know, because you play my songs off of my current CD, 21 Summers, I currently am taking up residence in your closet right here in the studio.
All right.
Did you get to the Grammys, John?
I did. I had a ball.
Awesome.
I had
awesome,
a ball.
Awesome.
That cute little gold guy, you know, Oscar, he was there. Oscar? The
Oscar.
Cute little gold statue guy, Oscar,
that's,
he was there.
That's the wrong...
No, he was there in support of the little gold record player, the Grammy.
Okay, I was going to say, maybe you went to the wrong award show.
No, that would have been in my Grammys, which was my grandma. She has a little gold guy. Oh, that on the front lawn.
All right, John, I'm going to just kind of move you over here for a second.
Sorry, Hammer, don't worry. I'll be over here in the closet.
Listen, we've had artists go on and do fantastic things. John Schrader, and I love him dearly. Annalisa Azadian was on the show, and she went on to American Idol. She's going to be huge. And I actually think these guys are going to be huge.
I believe it.
You got to check them out on YouTube, because the visual presentation is a good part
awesome.
Of what they do. Without any delay, in the Underground Spotlight, our featured artist of the week is Sir Curse. Here's Tarot on the Electric Radio Show. Obviously, I'm not kidding around.
That was good. That was good.
Awesome. Wow. Awesome. Awesome.
Wow. Now, you got to go to their YouTube channel. They got a few videos up there. Check out their other stuff. I just love, like, I can't even describe it. Like, you have to see it. You have to see these guys.
Yeah.
It's like a very dark carnival atmosphere.
Yeah, I mean, they're all like, you know, kind of done up and, you know, they're very theatrical.
Sir Kirsch, you guys are just awesome.
Really,
I really
good stuff.
New fan. The minute I heard the song, Andre said, check him out on YouTube. I subscribe to their YouTube channel. Yeah. Hit him up on Facebook. Hit him up on Instagram. And boom, boom, boom. 1, 2, 3. I'm an instant fan.
I'm going to rock that in my car.
Yeah, I'm definitely rocking that in my car.
I most definitely will check them out.
Check them out. It's Sir Kirsch. It's Taro. If you want to be just like them and get your project some love, all you have to do, theelectricradioshow.com. Click on the banner for the Underground Spotlight. All the details are right there. If you wanted to get a vanity plate and your state said, no, I don't think so. Would you be upset about it?
Well, I mean, it depends on what the vanity plate is.
This vanity plate...
There's got to be a reason why they said no.
Well, this vanity plate, what he wants is just simply his last name.
Oh. What's his last name,
And they said no. Well, you want to know what his last name is? That's coming up next on the Electric Radio Show.
And now, Valentine's Day tips from the elderly.
Sure wish they'd get rid of this stupid Valentine's Day movie night at the retirement home and replace it with a bowl of free Viagra.
This has been Valentine's Day Tips from the Elderly.
Secret this Valentine's Day, I must tell ya. No, I don't practice Santeria, I don't drive a Kia. I'm not from North Korea, but I'm sorry to say, my dear Leah, but I've given you gonorrhea.
It's the Electric Radio Show. All right. Some people may say only in Canada, but from the CBC, you know, let me start by saying this. It's never a good sign when life imitates Seinfeld. All right, we'll start right there.
Okay.
There's a guy in Melville, Saskatchewan, Canada, whose real name, this guy's real name, is Dave Assman. All right, and he's upset. He tried to get a vanity plate with his license, with his real name on his license plate. The government said no. And yeah, all right, Seinfeld fans out there, back in, I think it was around 1995, there was an episode of Seinfeld where Kramer got license plates that said Ass Man on there, and they were supposed to go to a proctologist. Yeah. You remember that?
Yeah, I remember that.
All right. Now, as for Dave Ass Man, he said he's proud of his name. He said, quote, it's my last name, I've always had it, and I'm not ashamed of it. There's nothing bad about it. And he's actually appealing the decision to block the plate, but he's really not optimistic. And, oh, by the way, it's actually pronounced Osman.
Osman. There you go.
Yeah.
But I was going to say, where does that name derive from, you know, Ass Man?
Yeah, we say Ass Man. And tell me, come on, we're all New Yorkers here. Tell me if that wasn't taken, that you'd get that plate in a second in New York.
I think so, especially it being your...
I think you would get Ass Man in New York.
Especially
I honestly
if it's your
do.
Real well, last
you can,
name.
You can go on the New York State Department of DMVs and see if it's taken.
I'm going to look right now. I'm going to look right now. What do you think, D? What is it? Well, let me look up DMV.
I wonder if it's one of those names where, like, you know, if your family was a blacksmith and, you know, like your name is like Mr. Blacksmith or something like that. And this is Mr. Ass Man.
All right. I am currently on the New York State Department of Motor Vehicles website.
Is it taken?
And license plates. I'm looking for renew, replace.
There's a spot in there because I just renewed my registration.
Renew license, replace license, check license. Come on.
There's a spot there for vanity plates. Google it.
Oh, for the love. This is why New York is so screwed up.
This is why you always have me look for stuff because I find it so much faster.
Look for it. Look for it and then type in Ass Man. Because I'm telling you right now, if it's available, you can nail that in New York in a second. Now, places like, all right, obviously Saskatchewan, Canada, you can't do it.
Maybe I'll put that on my car.
I'm just going to get a sticker that says Ass Man. And I'm going to put, like, I'll have it made up like a Canadian license plate. I'll do it in solidarity.
All right. So here I found
it. To Dave Osman.
I found it. All right. So.
Okay. So type in Assman.
Look up this plate. And it says to me, sorry, this plate combination is not available.
Oh.
That could be, though, because somebody has it. Let me try Ass Man with, like, a number after
Type
it.
Ass Man 1. Ass Man 69.
Oh, my goodness. You mean 68.
Yeah.
And of course, this has to be on my phone.
Oh, come on, for God's sake. Was this when you become prim and proper?
No, every combination of Ass Man with numbers is not letting me, it's telling me it's not available. But it doesn't tell me you can't have it. It's just telling me it's not available.
It's not available.
How about Ass Man, the number 4 and the letter U?
Ass Man for you.
D-Lite, I think that may be too many.
That is not the first time you've typed ass into that phone. Come
on. Yeah, or man. Just saying.
No, everything I'm putting in here.
All right, we're going to see if D-Lite can keep searching ass man in the state of New York.
It's probably taken by our old boss.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Oh,
yeah,
dear.
That would be like REALASSMN.
No, yeah,
coming up, no, D-Lite's going to give you all the deets in Tinseltown. Hollywood Hotwire is next on the Electric Radio Show.
This is a Valentine's Day alert. Valentine's Day alert. Men, T-minus 8 hours and counting to locate a gift. Do not hesitate to shop immediately. Under no circumstances should you wait until you are forced to present a rose with a 7-Eleven price tag stuck to the stem, or you will face the wrath of an angry woman who will assume you don't think that she is important and who will not assume the position you desire tonight. Must locate gift. The survival of your relationship depends on it. Valentine's Day alert.
It's the Electric Radio Show on demand. Always available right here on your phone, iPad, computer, or iPod. Tell your friends they just got to download it.
Do it now.
It's the Electric Radio Show podcast. It's funny as hell. The Electric Radio Show.
It's the Electric Radio Show. By the way, we tried man ass in the DMV search and it wasn't happening.
Yeah.
So, all right, we'll move on.
Might have been taken.
Could be. By our boss. Old boss. Now to give you all the deets, what's going down in Tinseltown. It's D-Lite with the Hollywood High. Hold on, D. I got to give you fresh music.
Thank you.
There you go. Take it away.
All right, taking a look around the internet for what's trending in Hollywood. Huey Lewis was forced to cancel his slate of 2018 concerts last April after he was diagnosed with I'm not sure how to pronounce this. Meniere's disease. It's an inner ear disorder. In a new interview with the San Francisco Chronicle, he says he hasn't given up. The singer first became aware of the problem before a show last year when he was in a hotel room with his bandmates and suddenly everything sounded like a blur. He looked at us and said, "I can't hear a word you guys are saying," said drummer Bill Gibson. They played the show that night anyway, but Lewis struggled through it and the rest of the tour was canceled. Now, there is no known cure or cause for this Meniere's disease. And in Lewis's case, it comes and goes. So planning a tour makes things very difficult. So they are releasing a new album. It's their first album in a decade, and it's due in the spring, but it doesn't look like they're going to be able to tour in support of it.
Oh, man. I've seen Huey Lewis twice in concert.
I've seen him, too.
I've seen him in Germany when I was there. I was stationed there, and I saw him there, and I saw him once in New York.
I saw him in New Jersey a couple of years ago.
He was put on a great show, yeah. Man. I hope. Come on, Huey. You got to get better, man. Get out there again.
All right, Bill Cosby has entered the general population last month at the Pennsylvania State Prison, where he's serving at least 3 years and is being treated, quote, like any other inmate, a state correction spokesman said.
Oh, keep your hands off there.
81-year-old Cosby was removed recently and is now in a single cell without a cellmate, which is typical for that facility. The comedian, once known as America's Dad, was found guilty last year of aggravated indecent assault for drugging and sexually assaulting Andrea Constand in 2004. Cosby was sentenced in September to 3 to 10 years behind bars at the State Correctional Institute. He is listed simply as inmate number NN7687.
That's racist.
like all other general population inmates, Cosby must be accounted for in his cell 7 times a day.
That's right. I like a Jell-O General Pop.
How far he's fallen.
I fell so far down I can't get up.
Ugh.
Now, bring me that stick.
All right, Sharon Osbourne revealed that heavy metal icon Ozzy Osbourne has been hospitalized for complications from the flu. A spokesperson for the 70-year-old rocker announced that after initially postponing the first 4 dates of his No More Tours 2 because of the flu, a follow-up visit with the doctor revealed a diagnosis of a severe upper respiratory infection, which resulted in the postponing of the tour's entire UK and European run. Doctors are concerned that the infection could develop into pneumonia, given the physicality of the live performances and the extensive travel schedule. We wish Ozzy the best and hope for a quick recovery.
Wow. Ozzy, man, come on, dude. You got to go out on tour.
I didn't know he was 70.
Yeah, well, I knew he was up there. I knew he was about 70, but Oz, wow.
So that's what's twinkling in Tinseltown this week. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram at The Electric Radio Show. Oh.
You didn't think. Oh my God!
Is that
look,
him?
He's in a hospital gown.
Oh. And he's dragging his IV bag with him.
What are you doing?
Hospital couldn't keep me away from my favorite radio show.
Hey,
because it makes me go crazy. That's how it goes. Ozzy bag. I'm touching my toes. Oh, yeah. My rectum chair.
Oh, no.
I'm here for the flu. What the heck? Hey, nurse. Put back on your probe. I've got problems with my tummy, not my hose. Going off the rails on a crazy train.
All right, yeah!
Keep that thing away from me, my friend. I swear to God, I think I would get a better recovery at home listening to the dog barking poo all over the place. Sharon, get me out of here. Ozzy Osbourne.
All right.
We have a lot of fun with Ozzy, but Ozzy, we love you on the Electric Radio Show, mm-hmm. and we wish you a speedy recovery. Get back out on the road and keep going, man, because I want to see Ozzy and Jack's World Detour. I love that show, man. If you guys haven't seen that, you got to check it out. Ozzy Osbourne. We love you. Coming up in just a little bit, a shot of Haagen-Dazs. What is up with all these ice cream stories?
I don't know. Mm.
And wrong person to scam.
Hmm?
What is that?
What is that? Jagger?
And listener email on the way on the Electric Radio Show.
It's Valentine's Day, and what better gift to give your wife than the truth? Introducing the Honey, I'm Gay Valentine's Bracelet. She's suspected it for years, and it's time to end your charade of a marriage so you can finally leave her to be with your longtime male companion. The Honey, I'm Gay Valentine's Bracelet features 2 solid gold men entwined in a loving embrace, so each time she looks at it, she'll remember that you didn't leave her because of anything she did. You simply left her because she's not Tony or Dave or Alan. That's the Honey, I'm Gay Valentine's Bracelet. Because she deserves it. And because you're homosexual.
Do you know what day it is?
It's Valentine's Day!
Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day, everybody!
I don't really celebrate Valentine's Day.
Why not?
Why not?
The heart was ripped out.
On Valentine's Day?
Yeah.
I've had it with Valentine's Day.
Nothing makes sense on Valentine's Day.
It's not supposed to.
Anyway!
Happy Valentine's Day.
You too.
One more thing.
One more thing.
It's showtime!
I'm all out of love. I'm so lost without you. I know you were right, believing for so long.
Don't tell me it's not worth trying for. You can't tell me it's not worth dying for. No, it's true. Everything I do, I do it.
Happy Valentine's Day.
I think of the female genes in a more positive light.
You've moved your relationship to the next level. How's it been going?
I want to be there for you.
I love you.
Having sex.
We all have one or two heartbreaks in our life.
I bought you some flowers and candy.
Can you tell when a girl looks at you and is thinking how much she likes you and wondering if you like her, but thinking how important it is for you to say how you feel before she says anything more about how she feels about you?
The teddy bear has been compromised.
Oh, you are not in love.
Listen up. This will only take a second.
I'm going to come at you like a spider monkey.
Hey, you shut your face. If we want to hear you talk, I will shove my arm up your ass and work your mouth like a puppet.
From the radio station that never uses pre-recorded voices, here's the show that would probably watch more Oprah if she would start doping. The show that keeps its imaginary college girlfriends where they belong. In the bathroom, after the wife has gone to sleep.
Let's have a great day, everybody.
Shut your pie hole. We're working here.
It's the Electric Radio.
All right. Love it. Coming up in just a little bit, he's all set, ready to go to give you your metaphysics for the week. Sacred Owl, the Zodiac Maniac, is on the way.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
But coming up shortly, we have another opine from a listener. A listener email is on the way. Yeah. I tell you what, you scam enough people, eventually you're going to scam the wrong one.
Oh, yeah.
Andre's got that story coming up. And another ice cream story. I think maybe we're just getting ready for spring. We got a little spring fever going on. Boost-filled Haagen-Dazs ice cream is finally available in the U.S.
I'm going to
tell you all about it coming up next on the Electric Radio Show.
Welcome to the Smoochy Poo I Love You Hour.
Outrageous, irresponsible, completely insane.
Nobody is listening.
Nobody escapes unharmed.
Nobody likes a Debbie Downer.
Nobody likes a Drunky Chunky.
Nobody is getting anything till they give something back.
We love this show.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Of course. You're going to talk about boost-filled ice cream. Why not have a little tequila?
Of course.
Back in 2017, think back. Haagen-Dazs started selling booze-infused ice cream in our neighbors to the north country in Canada. And now, just now, it's finally available in the U.S.
All right.
They won't have an ass man license plate, but they'll let you get loaded on ice cream.
That's true. Booze cream.
Love it.
There are six different flavors. There is Irish cream brownie. Bourbon vanilla bean truffle.
Yes. Ooh.
Stout chocolate pretzel crunch.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bourbon praline pecan.
Yes.
Yes. All right. We got it. We got more here. We have rum Trace Lachaise.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
And the rum Trace Lachaise. And a non-dairy option, amaretto black cherry almond toffee.
Well, that actually sounds good.
Yeah. That sounds delicious.
All right. But there's sad news, of course, because this is the U.S., the sad news is probably it's going to be next to impossible to get drunk on them because the alcohol content is 0.5%.
Of course.
So you would have to eat a ton of this ice cream just to get a buck.
I'll bet you it wouldn't take me much.
You
can look at it and get drunk.
What do you think, Dee?
Yeah, but I eat a lot of ice cream.
If I try the sleeping ice cream, will you try?
Absolutely, without even a doubt.
The booze-filled ice cream.
Absolutely.
All right. So what we have to do, and I'll leave this to you.
Oh, you're going to leave it to me to try to track them down?
Track down the sleep ice cream because I think I could probably find the boozy stuff. I don't think I'll be able to really have too much of a hard time.
Or we could just make our own.
Yeah, I bet you ice cream would be a lot more fun.
I bet you it'd be a lot more
than Haagen-Dazs, yeah. I have to honestly say.
Pour like a half a bottle of bourbon in
it. Yeah, it'll be Hammerdash.
Do you even know how to make ice cream?
No.
I do.
We know how to buy ice cream, though.
I know how to eat ice cream.
I have an ice cream maker at home, so I do.
So should we, you know what we'll do? Maybe we'll do this. We'll get some of the Haagen-Dazs, booze-filled ice cream, and then me and Sacred Owl and Andre will make Hammerdazs.
Hammerdazs, I like that.
Hammerdazs.
So I would have the actual Haagen-Dazs
ice cream? Yeah, well, you wouldn't know. Because you would have to do a blind taste test.
Oh, this is getting better and better by the second.
Isn't it? It's awesome.
I love this idea.
A devious little bastard, aren't I?
Bastard, you.
So maybe we'll try it out. I really do want to try the sleeping ice cream anyway, so this could all work out.
I think the Hammerdass might be some sleeping ice cream.
There you go. Hey, good day.
And I'll bring my ice cream maker here.
We'll do it all right here.
We'll do it right here.
Coming up, what happens when you scam the wrong person? Mm-hmm. Andre's going to tell you. Coming up on the Electric Radio Show.
And now, Valentine's Day tips from the elderly.
I've never seen that Cupid fella, but if he's sneaking around the retirement home with that bow and arrow, he should know a lot of people around here have firearms.
This has been Valentine's Day tips from the elderly.
Don't forget it's Valentine's Day.
What? Again?
I was at a red light the other day, and the guy was selling roses, you know? And I don't get one, but then I just thought, I need some points, man. I got to score some points. You know, guy, it's all about points. Ladies, I don't know what game we're in with you, but you always have the lead. You're always in front. By the way, the rose, if you're married for a while, that rose on the corner, that doesn't work. No, it doesn't. Yeah. No, it doesn't. I know. Because they know where you got it. They're like, oh, thank you. Thanks for the effort. Hey. Thank you very much. Thanks for rolling down the window. Yeah, you need a little more. You actually lose points. You might lose points.
It's the Electric Radio Show. What happens when you scam the wrong person?
And there's a lot of scammers out there.
There's tons.
A lot of crap going on.
Yeah.
So, 94-year-old William Webster. Does that name ring a bell, Jack? William Webster?
It does, actually.
William Webster, he lives in Washington, D.C.
All right.
With his wife, Linda. So, they got a call about 4 years ago from a man who threatened to set their house on fire and shoot them.
Oh, my God.
If they didn't pay him thousands of dollars.
No, this I don't remember.
Okay, so what the guy didn't realize, the scammer, is... William is a legend in law enforcement. He's the only person who's ever been the director of the FBI and the director of the CIA. He headed up the FBI from 1978 to 1987 and the CIA from 1987 to 1991.
Oh, wow. That's right. He headed up the CIA.
William Webster.
Under the last year of Ronald Reagan, George W. Bush, and Bill Clinton.
So... in a nutshell, you don't mess with this guy.
Dude.
So when he got the first scam call, he immediately called the FBI. And when the guy kept calling, William and Linda kept alerting the FBI. And Linda even had an agent listen in on one of the calls.
And they're like, hey, Bill, well, come on over. We'll bring the whole posse. Hey, send the CIA, too.
So the FBI traced the calls to a 29-year-old man in Jamaica named Kenyol Thomas. And when he flew to New York in 2017 to visit a friend,
he instantly
was arrested.
What a jerk.
He's been in jail ever since, and he was just sentenced to 6 years in prison for trying to scam the Websters and successfully scamming several other elderly people.
You know what's hilarious? Is if you pick up, and I want you to Google search this, because what I'm about to say is legit.
Okay.
Elton John's Goodbye Yellow Brick Road album. Mm-hmm. Search this. There's a tune on there called Jamaica Jerk Off.
Really?
Yeah. And it's this guy.
Huh. I didn't know that.
Yeah. So, check it out. It's a real tune.
This guy, he got 6 years, and he's going to be deported back to Jamaica when his sentence is over in 6 years. So he'll be here for 6 years.
Yeah, 6 years. Three hots in a cot.
Yep.
Unbelievable.
So, you know...
And you know what? It really sucks. Q talked about this last week in his What's Up. Was the harassment that you get now via text.
Right.
Which is these scammers. And they got pissed because Q used an expletive.
Well, you know, you used to get those scam calls and stuff on your home phone.
Yeah.
Now it's in the mobile world.
I'm
telling you, my phone is ringing all day.
I don't answer my phone either.
I don't answer them either.
Like, everything goes to voicemail. I call back who I know.
Yep. If you somehow get my cell phone number and you're not in my contacts, you're going to get my voicemail.
It's true.
And, you know, if it's not in my contacts, if you're not in there, like when my phone goes off and it's Andre, it says Andre Kane.
Yep.
Got his cute little picture.
Which
D-Lite
one?
D-Lite calls? Huh?
Which one? Is it the one with my shirt off?
Nope. It's the one where you and I were at the Yes Network.
Oh, okay. That's
so,
a good picture.
D-Lite
what
calls?
What picture do you have of me?
I don't have a picture of you. Yours
really?
Just comes up as D-Lite.
Not the picture with D-Lite's shirt off?
No, I wouldn't put that on my phone. My wife would see that.
Oh, that's true.
That one is it. I have like this little vault device on the phone.
Right.
I call that one D-Lite Nip Slip. Or was that Secret Owl Nip Slip? I can't remember. So be careful of who you're scamming out there. Could be the head
of the
FBI and the CIA.
You never know.
On the way, we've got a listener email coming up on the Electric Radio Show.
Reason why I want a divorce.
My funny Valentine.
She's a miserable, rotten
sweet comic Valentine.
I ended up marrying my kid's uncle.
You make me smile with my heart.
I have been married 25 years. I have not seen the man in 13 years.
Your looks are laughable.
He took my truck, and now he wants all my furniture.
Unphotographable.
The reason why I want a divorce, she's a selfish.
You're my favorite.
He broke into the house and destroyed almost everything I had.
Stay, little Valentine.
I would like a divorce.
Stay.
I was 17 and my husband was 14 at the time that we got married.
Today,
selfish
is Valentine.
I don't want to be married to a loser.
Day.
The reason I think I should get a divorce is because my husband's a drinking, gambling, cheating SOB.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Let's take a look at listener email. I don't know if you could top the last two we had. We'll give it a shot. This one is from Timothy in, quote, a town near New York City.
Okay.
All right, this is already starting off good. I don't know, Timothy, you may have this one. Dear Studio ERS, I work in a large department store in the tri-state area, and with the decline of brick-and-mortar stores, they have us employees covering multiple departments at the same time. With such little supervision and a much smaller amount of foot traffic, it allows me to, quote unquote, take stuff without anyone noticing.
Oh, boy.
It's almost too easy. I'm able to subsidize my pretty crappy income by selling the stuff I take online. Part of me feels bad because in the end I'm stealing, but part of me is like, who cares? They have us spread pretty thin, and every time we get our loss reports, our numbers are really good. So obviously what I'm taking isn't hurting the company. I'm able to earn an extra $100 to $200 a week. Let me see. Yeah.
That's not bad.
That's substantial. The problem I'm facing is I always thought this would be temporary, just to get myself out of debt or just until I earn enough money to buy a new computer.
Why would you buy a new computer? Just take it.
Just take the damn thing, right? You can't get that one into your ass crack.
Oh, okay.
Ass man.
Wow, check this out.
This is the ass man.
Check this out. He says, I've been doing this now for almost 2 years.
Wow.
And I feel like I can't stop. I feel like it's almost becoming an addiction. Should I get help? Will a therapist turn me into the cops? I don't know what to do. Timothy, in a town near New York City.
No wonder he wouldn't give his town.
That now makes sense. I honestly did not read this email until right now. I mean, I heard it as you guys heard it. Dre.
Well, obviously, he trusts us.
Yeah, but I can.
We just put it out on the air.
I'm telling you right now. He says he works in a store in a tri-state area, so that's New York, New Jersey, Connecticut.
Right.
His name is not Timothy, right. And he is not in a town near New York City.
Right.
These three things you can take to the bank.
I'm sure.
Although he did say tri-state area.
Yeah, so he's in New York, New Jersey, Connecticut, but he's not in a town near New York City.
Mm.
And I bet you his name's not Timothy either.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Guaranteed.
Great, what do you think?
Well, I mean, if you really do believe that you have a problem, yes, you need to get help for your problem.
Oh, I have a problem, too.
I mean, that's pretty serious, man. You're stealing, you know. I mean, you can go to jail for that.
Serious,
I mean,
man.
Can, you know, and everything might be cool now, but all it takes is, you know, some manager somewhere to realize that, hey, where's this stuff going?
Yeah.
And the next thing you know, you're in handcuffs. So
I got to know. All right. So what do you say? What does he do?
I mean,
he wants to know. He said, should I get help? Will a therapist help me or turn me into the cops? I don't know what to do. So obviously, he said, I feel like it's almost becoming an addiction. So.
Yeah, so I think you should get help. If you can't stop, get help. Go see a therapist. I don't think the therapist is going to turn you into the cops.
Yeah.
I think there's some sort of doctor-patient...
It's illegal.
I would think, yeah.
Doctor-patient confidentiality.
I think so.
They can't do it.
No. So I would talk to somebody about it.
So go see the rapist.
If you can't help, can't stop. If you can stop, man, stop. Stop right now. That's terrible.
All right. Dee.
So this kind of stuff, and we see it all the time in the news. Like, you'll see somebody got caught stealing $800,000 over a span of 3 years from some, you know, local business.
It happens.
This stuff snowballs because you get away with it one time.
Can you say that one more time?
This stuff snowballs.
A little slower.
Stop it.
Take snow off.
Anyway.
Wow.
I know, I'm terrible with dealing.
Yeah.
Wow.
So anyway, it becomes a major problem. So you've already been stealing for 2 years at about $200 a week.
Yeah.
I'm just going to do some quick math here. What is that?
About $104,000.
Is it? Is it really that much?
Well, 52 weeks in a year, 52 weeks. Let me see.
Anyway.
Get the calculator.
Anyway, you've already admitted that you have a problem. You have to go to a therapist. If you're concerned that they're going to
$20,800.
If you're concerned that they're going to turn you in, don't tell them the store that you work at. Okay.
Yeah.
But you need help.
Force you to confess.
You need help. You seriously need help.
Yeah.
Because this is gonna go out of control, and you're gonna get caught doing something. I mean, you're already doing something stupid, but.
So go to the rapist.
Don't say that.
Oh, therapist. Sorry. Okay. You.
Well, I agree with Andre and Dee-lite. But here's the thing. I worked with somebody who had that same problem. It's once they get away with it, it's impossible to stop. What I suggest he do is actually look for another job somewhere else.
Mm.
That way.
In a place with stuff you don't want.
Right. And yeah, that's true, too. But and also see a therapist. Do both of that. But once you get yourself out of that environment, the habit won't pick up that habit again where else you go. And try to go to a place that has good security. So that way you're not tempted to do that. But he is beyond he's an addict now. He's beyond help. He's beyond help at that store. And one thing, don't admit that you're doing it at the store. Just go, like you said, go to your therapist. I know in the tri-state area, there's some laws that you can't, a therapist can't turn you in.
It's doctor-patient confidentiality.
Something like that. And so, but I know that because the work I do, I'm a licensed minister in New York State, and I can't say certain things to anybody about what people come to me with.
Sure.
So he needs to stop working there, disconnect himself from there, find another job, and in the meantime, try to minimize what you take. I mean, you're not going to stop.
Yeah.
So try to minimize what you take and make it less and less and less, and start cutting back your living expenses, because you're not going to be living that high unless you find a job that covers the, what is he said, $28,000?
No, he stole $10,400 a year.
Yeah, so if you get a job that pays you $10,000 or more, then you don't have to worry about the money difference. But
he's saving up for a computer.
Yeah, but he's got to go.
A really nice computer.
He's got to get out of there.
Timothy, if that is your name. Tim, look, if you're worried about going to a therapist, if you have any kind of spiritual belief at all, go see a clergyman.
That's true.
Go see a clergy. Then it doesn't matter if you're Catholic, go see a priest or minister, Jewish or rabbi, whatever your faith is, and talk to somebody. You'll start to feel better about it. They'll give you some guidance. Unless you go to a clergyman, it's like, wow, can you get me a watch?
Oh.
But they won't. You know, if you're worried about getting turned over to the cops, there you go. But all these guys gave you great advice. There you go. Good luck to you, Tim. If you want to be just like Timothy, I don't want to hear about you stealing stuff. Just send us a listener email. StudioERS@gmail.com. Subject line, listener email. Zodiac Maniac is on the way, coming up on the Electric Radio Show.
Roses are red and violets are blue. You looked great last night. Now get the f*** out. Happy Valentine's Day.
It's the show that gives you multiple eargasms.
Oh, yeah.
Here you go, baby.
It's the Electric Radio Show.
Found at theelectricradioshow.com.
Valentine's Day acquires its name from a Catholic saint.
My real life escape from your love dungeon was the most exciting thing I've ever done.
February 14th was significant not only for its religious meaning.
Are you really going to get him something?
But because it was widely believed that birds began to mate on this date.
Flutter your wings!
Sweet love.
I think I'm too hard to be in love with.
Really?
It ends up on the cover of every magazine. I scare people away.
Not getting any love from her anymore.
I really, truly loved him.
You're a heartless jerk.
Tell my friends I died kissing a girl.
Let me just put on some romantic music.
The custom of sending Valentine cards grew popular in the 18th century.
Speaking of chemistry, kiss me, baby.
At this stage, we can complete each other's sentences.
Valentine's Day is as popular as ever with children and couples.
Get him a woman. That'll end his misery.
Yeah, you were one drunk little minx last night.
It's definitely one of the biggest money-making days for florists, candy makers, and gift shops.
If I want to spend money on a stripper, I'll take some at the shop.
I can honestly say that every gift I've ever given has brought at least as much happiness to me as it has to the person I've given it to.
If you're really into Valentine's Day and you're dating someone who's not into Valentine's Day, it's best to figure out what you're planning to do so that you don't expect this big show of affection.
It was the most tumultuous relationship of my entire life.
Here's what I love about you, Bill.
I really, truly loved him.
But whether you're single or coupled, you can navigate your way through Valentine's Day smelling like a rose.
That explains the poster in hygiene class. No glove, no love.
Love me some Britney.
People freaking love us.
Interpretive, postmodern, trendsetting. Oh, I love it.
But when I look into your eyes, I know you feel it too.
You sweet little angel.
We belong together.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day, a day of love.
I'm showing up with a dozen red roses and a box of fine Belgian chocolates. My lady don't care for no American chocolate.
Since it's Valentine's Day, I was thinking, let's do something we've never done before. I was thinking we could spend the whole day in bed.
We're connected by love.
My ex-girlfriend, she calls me drunk every Valentine's Day.
And in honor of Valentine's Day, I thought, why not go back in time to that summer of love in the 60s that everyone's always talking about?
It is going to be weird spending Valentine's Day by myself.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Oh, this has been the best Valentine's Day ever.
Connected by love.
Happy Valentine's Day.
They have-
have no idea there's a shocking wake-up call in store.
You're in a state of shock. Emotional trauma. Brain damage. He's got brain damage and doesn't even know it.
I told you what I do, and I drive around in my electric car, and people look at me like I'm the ice cream man.
Does your electric car have a little thing that goes...
See, that's the mistake. I did get that.
We're going to be the biggest thing since Edison harnessed electricity.
If you change that dial, you'll get an electric shock.
The devastation and destruction that has occurred to your face, it's really pretty shocking.
Do you want to become a shock jock? Is that what you want?
I am in shock.
It's just shock.
The neighbors down there that didn't have electricity managed to put together pots of soup.
What's that? Rove walked? First time he's done that in years. Seriously, did his legs go into shock?
Madam, you have suffered an emotional shock.
Stay in your seats. Please don't panic. We interrupt your entertainment for a shocking announcement. Electric
Avenue. It is the Electric Radio Show.
All right.
We got a lot more show to go. Coming up, we're going to give you guys some love for loving us all week on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We got social shout outs on the way, but straight ahead, it's time to get our metaphysic on. Sacred Owl. I almost called you Sacred Owl.
That's okay. As long as you don't call me Shady Owl.
Yeah, there you go. Sacred Owl is on the way. He's up next with the Zodiac Maniac. Electric
Avenue. We forgot.
What kind of a man does that?
Valentine. Stop smacking my head.
The Electric Radio Show.
How are you doing?
The Habbo radio station everyone loves.
I love them a lot.
It's the Electric Radio Show.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Time to bring it down a couple of notches. Get our metaphysic on. Sacred Owl, the Zodiac Maniac.
Well, thank you very much.
Sub Q.
I know. Well, my voice is coming back, so I can.
I noticed. Actually,
yeah. You know, I don't sound like all those people from the last couple of
but
shows.
Damn, you're still good on that flute. Look at him go.
Yeah. It's a small flute, though.
It's a very small flute. Oh, it's white. Check it out.
Sun is in Aquarius. During this cycle, we are motivated and hungered for relationships. So as this time is going on, people are going to feel very lonely, and especially with the weather being the way it is in the colder regions, people are going to get a sense of companionship and wanting to be very careful with that energy, because Venus is shifting to another energy, and I'll talk about that in a minute. And because it is, we're apt to make rash decisions in relationships because we're going to let the loneliness decide, dictate for us what we want to do and where we want to go and who we need to be with. And then you turn around 6 months from now, you're going to look over and you're like, I picked this person.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and it's just like, so be very mindful of that. Don't allow your emotions to dictate how you're going to deal in relationships. So with the Sun in Aquarius, and it's coming out very soon. So when we go into the Pisces energy, it's a whole nother intuitive level of energy that's going on. So mind you, with that, Venus is in Capricorn. And
with a V.
With the V, Venus. Getting serious about our finances and boosting our relations with business partners and coworkers will be easier than usual under this influence. So this is a time to start working on business and focus less on the relationship aspect. Venus is a planet that's actually projecting out the attitude of self-worth instead of looking at outside of yourself to find worth through a relationship or through other people. We take expressing our feelings very seriously during this time. So take your time to warm up to different people and make sure you keep very cool in jumping into any kind of relationships at all at this time. So
you're saying this is a better time to be looking at business aspects versus personal relationships.
Right. And looking at what you want personally to achieve.
Okay.
Because Venus is an energy of love. And the planet dictates relationships, but in this time, it's the relationship between you and you.
Okay. All right. Makes sense.
You know, and that. So, and now Mars is actually in Aries and is leaving Aries this week and is going into Taurus. So we're going.
And let me tell you, Aries is thankful.
Yes. Very Taurus. Very thankful.
Go bother Taurus for a while.
Exactly. Let those horns work for you.
That's
in a different
right.
way. But so with coming out of Aries, you know, we were very upfront and very direct. Now going into Taurus is determination, stubbornness, and resolution.
Okay.
So with all that, you know, you got to be very careful about Mars being Taurus. Being in Taurus is very passive, but it's also is very quick to take offense to people's statements and stuff like that. So don't pay attention to anybody and what they're saying to you. Make sure you think twice before you react to that. And this is a time here where any goals that you're setting, personal goals, are really going to set themselves into stone and become long-term and very, very satisfying. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Mars is conjunct Uranus also.
Oh, jeez.
Yes. Yes. So.
Damn, Mars is like all over here.
Yeah, Mars reminds me of my younger days. Anyway, so. All into everything.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you know. Hey.
All up in that business.
Absolutely. Wow. So right now, Mars being conjunct to Uranus, it's a tendency to take risks and you feel very restless. So be very mindful of making impulsive decisions. And like I said, take it cool, be easy. Don't rush yourself. This time now, what you're going to find out is probably a lot of people that have a schedule. The companies are trying to change the schedule, the work schedule hours. So it might change an hour here or a shift there. So be mindful of that. Be prepared for, so especially shift work. It might shift from instead of 7 to 3, 8 to 4, you know, stuff.
Or
like
you
that.
Could be working longer hours than normal.
Yes, you can be, but it's more of a scheduling time shift more than working more hours. So be mindful of that in dealing with all that. Now Mercury's in Aquarius and it doesn't cut it anymore. This Mercury being in Aquarius creates a lot of overthinking and overprocessing. So if you've been overthinking, your brain's been fuming out, stop worrying. Because remember, think about this. Anytime you worry, you're praying for that to happen.
No, okay.
Okay.
So you're feeding it.
Yeah, absolutely. So you want to get away from worrying. So with Mercury in Aquarius, it makes you worry too much. So change your intentions and you'll start to find out that more creative ideas will come to you and it'll help you out a lot. Now, Saturn is in Capricorn, responsibility, hard work, and ambition, and achievement. So this is the thing, what I said earlier, you want to focus on long-term goals and make those things happen, and you'll find that it really will settle in and help you out to the highest degree. Okay, so be mindful that with Saturn in Capricorn, everything is about order. Okay?
Yeah.
And Jade, a listener from Hollywood, Florida.
All right, Florida.
Yes, Florida. Asked about Capricorn. So pleasurable activities would be more appealing, as well as the temptation to be lazy. So you won't like things getting out of order because they can take a lot of effort to get back on track and put you up and behind even up to April. So be very mindful as your caps. Don't lose control of your organization. Don't lose control of your, you know, stay OCD. There will be no shortage of social occasions and which involve you, but you will have to learn to be very selective. Just don't jump at every party and make sure you do not overcommit yourself to anything that's out there.
Sacred Owl, the Zodiac Damn Maniac.
Thank you. Very good. Thank you very much.
And listen, like I've told you in the past, go to theelectricradioshow.com. Sacred Owl has his own page there. Click on it. I mean, you want to schedule a reading? Sacred Owl does readings, you know, in person. He does readings via FaceTime. He does readings over the phone. Like, you can get a hold of the man. You shoot him an email. It's right there. TheElectricRadioShow.com. Coming up, going to give you guys some love. Social shout-outs next on The Electric Radio
Show. I will all.
love you. Happy Valentine's Day.
It's Valentine's Day, and of course, millions of you will use FTD to send flowers to that special someone. But if that special someone is simply the latest in a long line of special someones, you might want to try the new flower service, STD. Choose the Valentine's bouquet. Inside a beautiful display of roses, baby's breath, and greenery, the results of your latest lab tests, proving that you are a walking clap factory. This bouquet doesn't just say, I love you. It really says, I love you, but I also loved a Venezuelan crack whore. This Valentine's Day, give her something in addition to what you've already given her. The new Valentine's bouquet from STD.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Give out a little bit of love. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram social shout outs, starting with Facebook from Cincinnati, Ohio. Right. We have Doug Lee in San Diego, California. We have Becca Robinson Weissman. Becca is a great girl, very, very nice girl. I ran into her, met her, I think in 20, was either 2016 or 15 at a convention, man. She was total Silent Hill. Did you see movie Silent Hill?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
She was dressed up as one of the nurses that was in that freaky weird thing.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God. She just pulled it off. So, Becca, thank you so much. And from Brooklyn, New York, we have Stacey Marie Donahue. So, thank you so much. Woohoo. Traveling on over to Twitter from Queensland, Australia, we have Stomp City Band. In Colorado Springs, Colorado, we have Ashley, I hope I get your last name right, Navarrete or Navarrete. It's one of those two. Mm. And in Central Florida, we have Gift Baskets to Go. All right.
All right.
So good.
Because
very
we're
good.
All basket cases here anyway, so it kind of fits.
We are.
And in Instagram land from Westbrook, Maine, we have Craft Maine Artisanal Beers.
Is that how you pronounce that? Artisanal.
However you pronounce it, we
however
love it.
However you pronounce it.
We're down with it.
Or if you really, if you break it down, it's art is anal. So,
Oh boy.
I'm sure it's Craft Maine Artisanal Beer in Westbrook, Maine. From Clifton Park, New York, we have Dennis Evans. And from Brooklyn, New York, Coldwell Banker Real Estate. All right.
Hey, you want to buy a house or what?
Yeah. You got a nice brownstone.
Come on
over
down.
Here.
We got something for you over here.
Got a brownstone in Bensonhurst. Come on out. Only $10 million.
God. Dude, I'm from Brooklyn. My God, man. Brooklyn has turned around like crazy.
Yeah.
Like where I'm from, I was from Bay Ridge in Brooklyn, right by Sunset Park. And it was crazy, man. It was just like this. And now it's like, you know, you got sidewalk cafes and all this crazy stuff, man. I'm just like, I just Google Earthed my old house in Brooklyn, and I didn't even recognize it, man.
Wow.
It's just,
that's awesome.
But did you Zillow it to see how much it's worth?
No, because
it'll make you sick.
Yeah, I know. I know what my parents sold it for in 1977.
don't Google that price.
I'm not looking at it in 2018, 2019 dollars. Ain't happening. You guys want to get a social shout out? All you have to do is go to theelectricradioshow.com. Click like, love, share. Who knows? You might get the next social shout out. Gonna wrap it up here in just a couple of seconds on the Electric Radio Show.
Because it pumps me up. It makes me happier. It makes me dance. Makes people laugh at me while I'm dancing when they walk in. But I do it.
If it's upbeat, it gives me energy.
We love this show.
The Electric Radio Show.
We're ending the show. And we hope you enjoyed it very much. Many things transpired here today. And we hope you stick around for whoever's next. Because they're really, really, really good as well.
All right, big finish.
Show's over, folks.
That's it. Go home, everybody. None of this ever happened.
Well, kids, that's our show for today. And now, in the words of Mr. Cole Porter.
Bye-bye, baby. Bye-bye, baby. Bye-bye, baby. Bye-bye. You.
That's going to do it.
All right.
Another flyby show of filthy, dirty, tongue-in-cheek humor.
That's okay.
We love it. That's why we bring it to you every single week. Hey, thanks so much. And don't forget, check out Jeff Chandler's podcast, TMI podcast. I'm going to put all the links up in our social media. Jeff, Jim, and Mike had a great time on that show. And I would do their podcast again. That's how much fun that I had.
I can't wait to check it out.
Yeah, TMI podcast that's out right now. Check it out. We'll put the links up. And thank you to you guys for checking out the Electric Radio Show.
Yeah.
Each and every week, growing like freaking crazy mad.
Mm-hmm.
Love you guys, man, truly. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. We love you guys for listening. It's what drives us to do this show and get together once a week, four friends, and just have a great time.
Absolutely.
So, thank you so much for listening. To our first responders, you guys rock. You gals rock. Police, fire, EMS, and dispatchers, you guys really do it, man. You give your community the safety and happiness to go about their daily lives every day. And my hat is always off to you. The greatest fighting force this world has ever known. The Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, Coast Guard, National Guard, Reserves. You guys all rock. You keep this planet safe from tyranny, oppression, and terrorism. Everybody take care. Be well. We're back here in a little over 6 days with another Electric Radio Show.
Take care. God bless.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you to all our troops. God bless America.
Here to perform our national anthem, United States Navy veteran and national recording artist, Dave Bray, USA.